We were all shown this diagram in school. We have a power source connected to a light bulb through a switch. And then we were asked what happens when we close the switch. The answer is the light bulb lights up. But what if I told you this concept was flawed? Let's go ahead and build the circuit and see what happens. Oh, that really isn't what I imagine in my mind when answering the question in school. So let's explore what is happening here. We know that in an electrical circuit, we get energy from the flow of electrons. These flowing electrons travel through metal connections in our circuit. So, of course, when we close the switch, the electrons start to flow, causing the light to light up. However, they will keep flowing faster and faster and faster till our entire circuit melts or explodes. Yikes. The easiest way to fix this problem is by setting up a speed limit sign and slowing down these electrons. Thankfully, we have an electrical component called a resistor that does just this. If we add one in our circuit, it takes those speedster electrons and it slows them way down and keeps our circuit in balance. In our circuit schematic drawings, we denote this part as a zigzag or a rectangle, depending on your preference. And the unit of measurement we use is the ohm. Let's zoom way into the resistor and see what's happening. Resistors are made up of materials that have a certain conductivity. The higher the conductivity, the less particles get in the way of the flowing electrons. The less conductive the material, the more electrons bump into particles and get slowed down. This creates a backlog of electrons at one end, which causes imbalance between the two ends of the resistor. And the more electrons we slow down, the larger this backlog becomes. This causes a voltage across the resistor to appear. That's great. We slow down the speed of the electrons, but we also created another problem. We know that from Newton's laws that we cannot create or destroy energy, only convert it. What we did is we converted the electrical energy into heat. So we need to make sure the resistor is able to handle that much power, or else that happens. But if you use some simple math, you can make sure you're using the correct size resistor, and your circuit should be just fine. Even the wire we use to connect our circuits can act as a resistor. The longer the wire, the higher the resistance. But now that I think about it some more, let's rewind and look at that light bulb circuit we had originally. Looking closely at the inside of a light bulb, we can see that it has filament that slows down the electrons and emits heat. Wait a second. They weren't lying to us all those years ago. Since a light bulb is a resistor, and that's why the circuit works. From one of the greatest inventions in human history to helping us light up our own circuit, one thing is certain. Our little friend, the resistor, is here to stay. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button. And if you love creative and interactive technologies, just like I do, don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of our upcoming videos. And I'll see you next time.